The Cappella Palatina we're exploring today was the church within the royal palace for the Normans who ruled medieval Sicily. It was squeezed between the palace residence and administrative offices. King Roger II began the church in 1131. It was officially dedicated in 1140. The work continued after that. In fact, many of the mosaics we're going to be seeing have been heavily restored over time. So why are we looking at this thing? We mostly study this church, not only because it's incredibly beautiful, but because of what it teaches us about the depth and complexity of artistic interactions in the medieval Mediterranean. When you start learning about medieval art, most of the works get put in tidy categories of specific cultural groups. But this church is here to remind us that the realities of artistic production are so much more interesting. Even this church's layout combines two often disparate architectural languages. This section follows the form of a Western medieval Latin basilica with its long rectangular shape. But the altar area of the church looks like an Eastern medieval, that is Byzantine, cross and square, naos plan with a dome. Let's look at other Byzantine aspects of the church, for it has a dazzling program of mosaics created by artists, likely coming from the Byzantine capital, Constantinople, since they closely follow the Comnenian style there, named after the Byzantine ruling family of the moment. Thus, this dome in Palermo, Sicily, is topped by a mosaic of Christ the All-Ruler, just as you'd find in Middle Byzantine churches made around the same time in what is now Greece and Turkey. In this way, the church decoration depicting Christ at the apex mirrors the Christian understanding of the ordering of the world. So the angels are just one step below Christ, but still above humanity. In other respects, though, Roger II's church would have felt comfortably familiar to people arriving from Italy. For the floor was decorated in the casmati style of richly hewed stones and simple larger shapes offset by bands of more intricate patterns as you see here. Also, Roger II had a grand Norman style throne inserted in the church design over which the king chose to have with his characteristic modesty an image of an enthroned Christ. Most of the nave mosaics follow visual formula more typical in Western medieval churches. For instance, the walls of the sanctuary and transepts depict the history of ecclesia, which means the church, in a series of vignettes from the Hebrew Bible and New Testament. In this detail, the top row shows what? Looking from left to right, we can see the creation of the earth, animals, Adam and Eve. This scene in the middle of that sequence seems to show Adam getting blasted with a laser beam, but it's the medieval art manner of showing God giving life to the first man, a message that's reinforced with that Latin inscription you can see up above. So we found Byzantine Greek and Latin Western medieval elements in the Cappella Palatina, but if you look above the creation scenes, you can see the church's McCarnice ceiling. Islamic artists came from Fatimid Egypt to craft this gorgeous wooden ceiling using the McCarnice technique, which is a kind of honeycomb structure you see across the Islamic world at this time. The wooden McCarnice ceiling includes all these wonderful painted vignettes ranging from scenes of courtly life, such as this grand courtier gracefully holding a cup, flanked by two attendants, to another painting that shows workers laboring to pull water up from a well. Also, not surprisingly, the Islamic artists adorned the McCarnice ceiling with golden Arabic inscriptions, as you see here, complementing the Latin and Greek inscriptions elsewhere in the Cappella Palatina. In this way, Roger II interwove artistic trends from around the Mediterranean, drawing on Byzantine, Western medieval, and Islamic traditions to create a coherent and mutually intelligible expression of his power. This meshing of diverse Mediterranean practices characterizes other works from Roger's reign, such as his famed mantle, which even is encircled by an Arabic Taraz inscription. And the Norman Sicilians in general, as seen in this later building, the cathedral at Monreale, built by Roger II's grandson.